Nano Banana Pro is here, and it's without a doubt the most impressive image generation model out there. You can use it to create high-resolution images with consistent characters, perfect text, and accurate physics. You can even generate 4K images using this model. And in this video, I'll show you the best way to add Nano Banana Pro to your n8n workflows. So let's have a look at what we'll be building in this video. First, I'll show you the easiest way to integrate Nano Banana Pro into your workflow using a single node. Then we'll step things up by giving ourselves way more control over the generation. So if I run this workflow, we can provide a prompt like a woman holding a coffee cup with a coffee shop in the background. She's wearing a dress and a hat. I mean, this is incredible. This looks like a professional photograph, and all the text is indeed readable. Look at the detail. We can also edit images. Let's upload the image we just generated, and let's say replace the coffee cup with ice cream and the background with the ocean and beach. Let's send this. And let's have a look at the result. And putting these side by side, we can see this is indeed the same character. She's got the same necklace, the same dress, same face, hair, hat, everything. How insane is that? Let's try one more. Let's click on edit image. Let's upload the image we just created, and let's say, create a YouTube thumbnail with the text, my best vacation. Let's send this. And how awesome is that? The text is totally readable, and this can definitely pass as a YouTube thumbnail. Then you'll also learn how to combine multiple elements to create one image. In fact, I think you can go up to 12 images, and then you can combine the elements of this image into a single generation. So let's select our character again, and let's say we wanted to change our character into a certain outfit or make her hold a certain product. So for example, let's say we wanted her to wear this hat. So in our form, I've selected our character, replace her hat with a black one. How cool is that? This is perfect for creating consistent characters and for promoting products. And there are just so many use cases for this technology. Nano Banana Pro is really amazing. You will find all the resources and this workflow in the description of this video. And if you like this content, hit the like button and subscribe. Enough talk, let's dive in. Right, so the question is, how do we access Nano Banana Pro? You could use a third-party provider, but honestly, I like to go directly to the source. That way, I don't end up paying additional fees and charges. So what you need to do is go to aistudio.google.com. We are going to Google because Google, if you didn't know, are the creators of Nano Banana Pro. So we are going directly to the source here. Now, what's really cool is you can actually test out Nano Banana Pro within this interface. But the reason we're here is to get our API key. So go to get API key. Then in the top, click on create API key. Give your key a name, like I'll just call mine n8n Nano Banana Pro tutorial. And then you also have to select a Google Cloud project. Now, by default, you won't have any projects. So all you have to do is click on create project. Then give your project a name and select it from your list of projects. Then let's create this key. Now the next thing you need to do is to set up your billing account. Now don't worry, when you sign up for a new Google Cloud Platform account, you will receive free credits. After I set up my billing account for the first time, Google gave me about $100 worth of credits. So you should be able to follow along for free. Either way, we'll keep this page open as we will come back to the API key in a minute. Then you also need access to n8n. Now there are many different ways to access n8n. I'll leave a link in the description to a video where I show you step by step on how you can set up n8n yourself on your PC. Of course, if you don't want to deal with the setup process yourself, you can definitely sign up for n8n Cloud by going to n8n.io. If you use the affiliate link in the description, you will be supporting my channel. But I do want to mention that n8n Cloud is not cheap. If we go to the pricing page, you'll pay about 24 euros per month. Now, to be fair, they do give you a lot of additional features that you don't get with the free community version. So if you are planning on building these workflows professionally, you might want to consider their service. Now, an alternative solution is to host n8n yourself on a VPS. Now, the easiest solution I found is to use Hostinger. And in fact, they currently have a Black Friday deal, which means you can host n8n for as little as $5 per month. So if you are interested, you can use my affiliate link. Then you can select between any of these packages, like KVM1 or KVM2. I'll go with KVM2. Then you can simply select your period. You can select your server location. And most important, under operating system, go to applications and select n8n. This will install n8n with a single click. Hostinger is giving my audience an additional 10% off, so under coupon code, enter the word Leon and click on apply. And this will give you an additional 10% off. Now simply continue to the checkout process. Afterwards, you'll have access to your dashboard, which should look something like this. Really, all we have to do is click on Manage App, and you will now have access to your very own n8n instance. So I'll go ahead and complete all of this information, then I'm simply going to skip this pop-up, and on this screen, definitely send yourself a free license key. Then go to that email and copy the key, and back in n8n, go to Settings, click on Enter Activation Key, paste in that key and click on Activate. This will unlock a whole bunch of very cool features. And now you're finally ready to build your very own workflows. So let's create a new workflow. Then I'll rename it to Nano Banana Pro Tutorial. And now we have to add a trigger node. Right, so the simplest way to add Nano Banana Pro to your n8n workflows is to use the Gemini node. So let's look for Google Gemini. And let's click on Generate an Image. Then under Credentials, click on the drop-down and select Create New Credential. And let's give it a name like Nano Banana Pro Tutorial. Now we have to provide our API key. So let's go back to Google AI Studio. Let's copy our key and add it to n8n. Let's save. And if everything was done successfully, you'll see this green success message. Then let's click on Model. Now, at the time of recording, the Nano Banana model is not available in this list. We only have access to the older version. So what we need to do is change this to by ID, and then we can replace this with models/Gemini 3 Pro Image Preview. Then let's enter a prompt, and you will notice we actually don't have a lot of options, like selecting the aspect ratio or the resolution of the image. We will fix that in the next step. But if you simply want a very simple image, then we can hit execute step. And it only took a few seconds and we have our image. And indeed, this is a dog eating a hot dog. So this solution works, but it's just too simplistic. We don't have a lot of flexibility here. So instead, I'm going to show you the best way of adding Nano Banana Pro to your n8n workflows. Let's start with a form. We can call this form, create image. Then for the field, let's call this prompt. For the element type, let's select text area. And this is a required field. Then let's execute the step. And let's say, a cute dog eating a hot dog. All right then, I'm just going to rename this node to create image. Then let's add a new action. In here, let's add the HTTP request node. Let's change the method from get to post. Then for the URL, I'm actually going to open this up so it's easier to see. We need to pass in this URL. So if you want, you can simply pause the video and then copy this URL. Then under authentication, let's create a generic credential type. Under generic auth type, let's select header auth. Then in this list, let's create a new credential. I'm going to rename this to Nano Banana Tutorial. And for the name of this auth property, we need to enter xgoog-api-key. Then again, we have to copy our API key and paste it into the value field. Let's save this. Then let's enable sent body. For the content type, we will be passing in JSON. And under specify body, let's select using JSON. And let's paste in all of this. Again, you can pause the video and copy all of this, or simply get it from the workflow in the description. Now, there's really not much to this. First, we've got this content part, and this is where we'll pass in our prompt. And underneath that, we have this object called generationConfig, which simply says that we have to enable these modalities. And very important, we can set things like the aspect ratio, as well as the image size. For the image size, we can do 1K, 2K, or 4K images. For the tutorial, let's just do 1K. We also want to replace this sample text with the actual prompt from the form. So I'll simply grab it from the left-hand side and drop it into this. Cool, let's close this pop-up. And that's actually all we have to do. Let's go ahead and execute this step. I'm also going to rename this node to generate image. All right, so the generation completed, but at this point, we don't see the actual image. We get this raw Base64 file. So there's only one more step we have to do. And let's search for convert to file. Let's select this node, and then let's select move Base64 string to a file. Now we can simply grab this data property and drop it into this field. And we can specify the name of the output property, which I'll just leave as data. Now let's run this. And now we can view this image, which also means we can use it throughout the workflow. Right, so how do we edit images? Well, it's really simple. I'm actually going to copy this form. Let's open it up and let's rename this to edit image. All right, let's add another element. This time let's call it image. And for the element type, we'll change it to a file. I'll just allow a single file. And if we want, we can definitely limit the types of formats that are allowed. I'm also just going to change the title of the form to edit image. Let's test this. I'll select the image of that dog eating a hot dog. For the prompt, let's say, I don't know, something like the dog is sitting on Sydney Sweeney's lap. This model is really good at creating celebrity images. Then for generating the image, let's actually copy this node like so. And let's open it up. The good news is we don't have to change the URL. It stays exactly the same for all of these nodes. And we've already set up our credentials, so we don't have to change that either. All we have to edit is our JSON body. So let's expand this. And all we're going to do is add one more line below the parts. So we will still be passing text like our prompt, but just below that, I'll add comma, and we'll actually add another object. And that looks something like this. So we've got this inline data property followed by the image. Now, very important, we can't just send the binary image into this prompt. We first have to convert that original image into Base64 and then pass that into this field. So how do we do that? Well, in between these two nodes, let's add another node. Then let's search for extract from file. Let's select this guy. So we're kind of doing the opposite that we did in the create node. We already have an image, but we need to convert it into Base64. So let's select move file to Base64 string. Then for the binary field name, we call this image. So let's replace data with image. I'll just leave the output field as data. Then let's execute this step. And now we get the Base64 encoded version of the image. So that means we just have to go back into this generate image node. And let's go back to the JSON body. And let's fix this up. So first we need to change where we're getting our text from. Now we have to go to edit image and then add our prompt from the form. Then for the image itself, we can now replace this placeholder with this Base64 version of our image, just like that. Then let's run the step to generate our image. And cool, it seems our image was generated, but again, we will receive a Base64 version of the image from the API. So all we have to do is convert it back into a file. So let's just connect these two nodes, and this should already work out of the box. So let's run the step, and let's download and view our image. And that's awesome. That definitely looks like Sydney Sweeney sitting with a dog eating a hot dog. Another powerful feature of Nano Banana Pro is its ability to combine multiple images together into a single image. So this is very similar to how we're editing images. So I'll just copy all of this. Then let's just rename this one to multiple images. And then in this form, let's actually call this multiple images. And for the form title, I'll call this multiple images as well. And of course, we'll still have our prompt and we'll be able to upload an image. So I'll just call this image 1. Then I'll add another form element. Let's call this image 2. And for the element type, I'll select file. I'll just upload 1. And we can make this a required field. I think you can upload up to 12 images to Nano Banana Pro. Let's just stick with 2 for the sake of this tutorial. Right, so let's run this. First, I'll upload the image that we just generated. And for image 2, let's select this pink hat. And let's say, Sydney Sweeney wears the pink hat. And let's submit this. All right, so we can now see both of those images being outputted from our form. So now we have to convert both of those images to Base64. We already have one node. So for this one, I'll just change this to image 1. And then I'm actually going to move these two nodes up. Let's copy this one. Then let's connect these two. like so. And for this one, we want to process image 2. And we also want to use a different name for the output field. Otherwise, this one is just going to overwrite the previous value. So let's just go back to this one. Let's call the output field image 1. So I'm actually going to test this step. So this should convert image 1 into binary. Then let's do the same thing for image 2. We just want to see that these steps are actually working. So yes, I am receiving the image. Now for the image generation. Again, we don't have to change the URL or the credentials. We'll simply adjust the body a bit. So let's expand this. And this is actually easier than you might think. I'm simply going to replace all of this with the Base64 representation of image 1. Now to add more images, all we have to do is copy this object containing this inline data for this image. Let's add a comma and then let's paste it. And now we can simply add the content of image 2, like so. I mean, this is really simple. Let's run the step to see if our image generation works. And it worked. So we have our image in Base64 format. So really all we have to do is run this convert step. Right, we've got our image. Let's download and view it. And how awesome is that? Sydney Sweeney is indeed wearing that pink hat. And as a reference, this is the image of the hat that I uploaded. This is just insane. So let me know down in the comments, are you impressed by Nano Banana Pro and will you be using it in your workflows? Let me know if you've got any questions. Remember to hit the like button and subscribe to support my channel. I'll see you in the next one.